Kids Fairfield area weather forecast for today, a 60% chance for rain, high 82. 80% chance tonight, low 74. Tomorrow, 50% chance for rain, high 82. Clouds and 85 on Thursday. For Friday, partly sunny, high 78. And the outlook for Saturday, sunshine, high 82. Overnight, low 68. Yesterday's high was 84. Currently, humidity at 96%, winds out of the north-northwest at 2 to 3 miles an hour, and the pressure 29.91. Right now, fog and 72 here at the WFIW studios east of Fairfield.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Mark Turner there, Mike Dreith here.
Can you believe it is the first day of September?
You know, I think you can go get your archery deer tags here in the next day or two.
I think it opens up today.
And then the season starts October 1st or thereabout.
Yeah.
So only a month away. Can you believe it? Mm-hmm. You know, I don't even get a hint. If there's any brown out there, it's because I think we need the rain so bad.
Yeah. Have seen, hey, I saw another big, thick black woolly worm yesterday. That means fall's coming.
Can you tell, you know, by the way he was moving, you know, what kind of a winter we're going to have?
I could not.
I mean, there's usually Tom Levine. But good morning, Tim. Tom, how are you?
We leave that to the apricot.
Tim's fine,
seeds.
Too.
Tiny Tim and Tom, both here. Last night I watched a documentary on Stevie Nicks. I found it very compelling. What a interesting person. She's, from Fleetwood Mac to her solo career, and I think I like her solo career stuff better than I did her Fleetwood Mac stuff. But she was a heavy contributor to the songs that were a part of Fleetwood Mac, that huge Rumors album from the, was it mid-70s?
Yeah, 76, I think, 75, 76.
There's a point in her life she got really, really messed up with cocaine and then painkillers, which were prescribed to take care of the cocaine. I'm just saying, I think that the cocaine might have been less hard on her than the painkillers. And there's also a point, about 13 years, where she really liked cool brand cigarettes. And you can tell, you know, the voice quality during that period of time.
Right, the raspy voice.
Very raspy, very distinctive. Really sad to hear the passing of Larry Graham. He was the head basketball coach for the Madison Trojans. And now, I think I've got this right. I will be corrected quickly by the sages of Fairfield. But I believe it was his team, the Madison Trojans, that knocked off the Fairfield Mules in 1979 at Eastern Illinois University in the Sweet 16, if I'm not mistaken.
That would have been the Super Sectional. Yeah, that would have been the Sweet 16.
And then it was... Fairfield lost that game. That ends their season. Madison goes on and wins the state tournament. And he won two state championships.
Won two. I think he took five teams to the Elite Eight.
That was my junior year. Sophomore, junior year.
You were up in the Quad Cities, though, right?
No, I was here.
You was here that time?
Yeah.
Did you?
I was a mule.
So you were a mule.
Yeah.
Do you remember that? Did you go up to Eastern?
No.
Okay, all right. Well, that was a big deal around these parts, I think.
Well, yeah.
Anyway, I went to the crop tour yesterday, noontime, JT's. I didn't eat anything, but let me tell you something.
Did they have fried chicken?
Oh, they did have fried chicken, yeah. And I said no.
And you said no?
Just say no. That's what Betty Ford told me to say. Just say no. No, that was Nancy Reagan.
Oh, Nancy Reagan.
Betty Ford had a problem, too.
She needed to say no.
Yeah, Betty Ford wanted you to say no.
Yeah, but she couldn't.
That's
anyway,
why she
actually she wanted
a center.
To say yes. I want to go to your center.
You know, the farmers are so nice. They're so very nice. I mean, the guys that were there were friendly and inviting and provided me with the information I needed as because it comes in, there's like a time crunch.
Right.
Here comes the stuff. We want to get it on the 12:15 news.
It's kind of like the election. It's kind of like election night. They all seem to come, the results all seem to come in at once.
And there's a hard deadline. I've got to get it in for the 12:15, and they realize that. It's the third year in a row that I was there. Third year in a row, I just about messed it up, too. Because what people want, they want the numbers. They want the numbers. And I'm talking, you helped me.
Yes,
and,
I know.
And so I'm calling it back, and I'm saying, tell me about, you know, overview. Greg Martin, yeah, give me the overview. And at the end of it, he said, well, you probably, I mean, this is a live, it sounds like a live report.
Right.
He said, you probably want the numbers. Yeah, let's start this thing over.
So, stop.
Let's give me the numbers first, and then let's talk about the
and
analysis.
Then he has the gall to ask me, can we start this over? And
yeah.
I was like, yeah, you have to start
have
it
to.
Over because you didn't give the numbers. You didn't ask for
and
the
you know
numbers.
What? That was the third year in a row I didn't ask. If it hadn't been for Greg.
You wouldn't have had the numbers.
I wouldn't have had the numbers. No. I had all the data. I had all the data on a piece of paper. I just didn't put
he
it
had
in the report.
That it looked good, and it might be near record for the crop tour. And
I didn't do any exciting things last night. I just mowed the grass.
You harvested some fescue.
I did.
And you enjoy doing that, don't you?
I like mowing the grass. Gives me a chance to solve all the world's problems.
Was it the proper height?
It was not at first.
Well, tell us that story.
Oh, let me tell you. So,
yes.
I got this lawnmower.
Okay.
The lawnmower works great. Don't get me wrong. But it was too low.
Mm-hmm.
My grass is thick. And it, I keep it high. I like to keep it, you know, I don't want it down to the nubs, down to the roots.
He wants it soft and fluffy.
Yeah.
So, yeah, go out and lay in the grass.
So, you know, if I come walking off the deck and fall, I don't get hurt.
He wants a cushion.
I don't roll around in the dirt. I just roll around in the soft grass.
On the weekends, is there an increased possibility that you could fall off your deck disoriented and into the grass?
There is not.
I bet there is.
And so
Tina throws it off the grass.
I decided I would raise the height.
Right.
Okay. Well, that's easy enough, right?
Right.
Well, let's just put it this way. It was stuck.
Yeah, you get
in the low position.
You had to get the hammer and...
I got the hammer out.
Get the hammer out? Or did you just get bigger tires?
I beat that thing like a red-headed stepchild. But I got it up to the proper height.
Good. Good for you.
And got back to working.
After I get done here... And I want you to notice something. What's different about... me today here in front of me.
Looks like you're organized.
I'm always organized.
Sorry.
I didn't think that was that funny.
Got the Cardinal shirt on, not
we
the WFIW
well,
shirt.
I'm going to St. Louis after
yeah,
this.
Yeah, I got it.
And I
show your pride.
I didn't want somebody while they're operating me going, what's with who?
With Fua?
With Fua? It's morning coffee. I don't have any
coffee.
You
don't have any coffee.
No, you don't.
You're coffeeless.
It's the first time
you're
that's
grogless.
Ever happened. I'm grogless. You know why?
No.
You can't drink anything, water, or eat anything 6 hours before you're operated on.
Really? You can't drink or eat anything?
Nothing. So that's the reason why I had my cup of coffee.
Yeah.
I had my cup of coffee, last hour.
Your cup of coffee?
Yeah. Sounds like I could fall on your grass before long. Anyway, so
well, you
even
spoke
it'd be
grass.
Nice and soft. You wouldn't stir up any dirt.
No, you wouldn't. It's too dry. We need to get some rain out of this. Anyway,
yeah.
So no coffee. I'm going to go get my eye operated on this afternoon. I won't be here tomorrow. You guys are going to have to hold it down. Well, it's KO Wednesday.
It's party day.
And by the way, what I'm going to do...
Ice cream.
After I get done here, Tom is going to aid me. I'm going to record a community connection with Sarah Fry about her new book, The Growing Season. That was featured on CBS Saturday Morning. It was on Fox News last week. It's getting great reviews. And so I can't wait to sit down and talk to her. She's a good friend.
You just wanted to talk about you being mentioned in the book, don't you?
Did you mention that?
You've told us several times.
You know, I got a call.
You know, I haven't heard that you were mentioned in the book.
Seriously?
Seriously? You have not heard that yet?
No, I had.
My name is in the book.
Did you write it in there, or
no?
This book belongs to Mike Dreeben.
No. Actually, it was funny because Sunday night I got a call from Representative Bailey.
Okay.
And he was listening to the audio version of Sarah's book.
Okay.
Because he was going from different spots around
from here to there and yonder.
And he heard my name. And he said, "I forgot I hadn't talked to you."
Hey, I know that guy.
Did they pronounce it correctly?
Sarah did. She's the one who read it.
Okay.
She voiced her own book.
Okay.
So anyway, it was nice that she mentioned me, and it was nice that he thought of me and gave me a call on Sunday night. So there you go. What do I have here in my hand?
You want coffee? Let's kick it. Bunk, bunk, baby. Bunk it up, bunk, bunk, baby. All right, stop. Sit back and listen. Mike and Mark have a little invention, a bucket, and it's full of junk. It's even got a title, it's the Bucket of Bunk. Fill it to the top with facts you might know. Turn on the mics and let's go. It's full of more facts than one mind can handle. Celebrity birthdays, facts, history, and scandals. Bunk, bunk, baby.
That's right.
Bucket of Bunk, bunk, baby. Bunk, bunk, baby. Bucket of Bunk, bunk, baby.
It's a bucket of bunk.
It is birthdays today. Conway Twitty, also known, especially at birth, as Harold Lloyd Jenkins.
Okay.
Would be
He didn't go with Harry Jenkins. He just went with
Conway Twitty.
Conway Twitty.
Remember that place, Twitty City?
Yeah.
was it
France or something?
No, it was near Henderson, Tennessee.
Okay.
That was $3.5 million right out of Conway's back pocket. He built it.
That's a couple of rhinestones.
Yeah.
You know, he was a rocker for a long time.
No.
Oh, yes. Absolutely. Anyway, he'd be 87 today. He died at the age of 59. Only 59 in 1993. Hello, darling. You remember that?
Yeah.
A neighbor suggested that he, when he was Jenkins, could make it in the music industry after he heard Elvis Presley sing Mystery Train. Jenkins began writing rock and roll and material, and he went to the Sun Studios in Memphis, Tennessee, worked with Sam Phillips, and he kept working on the right sound. Allegedly, in 1957, Jenkins decided that his real name was not memorable enough. I think we've established that.
So he changed his name to Conway Twitty.
Sought a better show business name, according to Fred Bronson of the Billboard Book of Number One Hits. Twitty looked at a map, spotted Conway, Arkansas, and Twitty, Texas, and chose the name Conway Twitty. A couple of darts.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
You know what? I've always wanted to be Oblong Effingham. Old Obby. I'm going to change my name to that.
Obby?
No, Oblong Effingham.
Oblong Effingham.
You know, a little bit later, I've got one of the most unique names to tell you about, but not right now. Okay, I'm still telling you about Conway Twitty. In 65, disc jockey's rock and roll was his, you know, what he was known for, and so country disc jockeys wouldn't play him. He didn't get on country radio until he had a top five hit, The Image of Me, in July of 68, followed by his first number one song, Next in Line, in November 68.
I can't imagine Conway Twitty with that rocker's haircut, man. Long, you know.
Yeah. He had kind of a bouffant up on top.
Right.
Good morning. You're on Morning Coffee.
Hello. You there?
You there? Hello?
Yeah.
Yes, I'm calling for Mr. Tom Levine.
Oh.
He's here.
Yeah.
Can you...
Okay.
Can you call back if it's not? We're on the air right now.
Yes.
Oh, my bad.
Okay.
Okay, well, you can call back in an hour.
Yep.
Okay?
All right.
He's so popular, Tom Levine.
I know.
People call in, they just...
And it wasn't just, I'm calling for Tom Levine. I'm calling for Mr. Tom Levine.
As I'm known.
Did you
on
notice?
The outside.
I mean, she seemed like Mr. Tom Levine.
I know. She was awestruck or something.
I know it. Well, he's a star.
Well, when you have to talk to the Tom Levine.
He's the biggest name in AM radio
in this
right. town.
You don't just Number get to one. Talk to Tom Levine. You get to converse with Mr. Tom Levine.
Who has, that is his
You're
going
to have to get a scepter.
That's his real name, I believe. You didn't come up with Oblong scepter. Effingham or anything like that, did you?
You may now talk to Tom.
In 1970, Conway Twitty recorded and released his biggest country hit, Hello, Darling.
Hello, Darling.
Spent 4 weeks at number one. Then he started having wonderful duets with Loretta Lynn.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Really, the kind of the first lady of country music. He
was
also...
Like Mississippi Man, Mississippi Woman, Louisiana Man, or something like that.
Yeah, After the Fire Is Gone was the first big one. Investors, he was an investor in the Nashville Sounds, a minor league baseball team in Double A Southern League. So he loved baseball.
Okay. Well.
And he lived for many years in Henderson, Tennessee. I told you about Twitty City. He was married four times to three different women. You do
okay.
the math.
Yeah.
Okay. Also on this date.
Did he marry himself one time?
Divorce didn't work out, so they got married again.
Ah, okay.
That happens a lot.
Yeah, it does.
Lily Tomlin is 80 years old today.
Wow.
Breakthrough roles that in Rowan and Martin's Laugh-In, 1969 to 73. She's currently on Grace and Frankie, right? Is that
yeah.
it?
Mm-hmm.
Debuted in 2015.
What
so.
Was the operator?
Ernestine.
Ernestine, okay.
And then she also did Edith Ann, if you don't.
Edith Ann.
Yep.
That's the truth.
That's right. In 1970, get a load of this. In 1970, AT&T offered Tomlin $500,000 to play her character Ernestine in a TV commercial. She declined, saying that it would compromise her artistic integrity. I've used that line many times here when people have offered me thousands to use my voice on their commercials. Wait a minute. I can't do that. That would compromise
my artistic
integrity.
How much did they offer?
Half million.
That my artistic integrity would be thrown out the window.
$600,000. Not so much.
She married longtime partner Jane Wagner in 2013. They've been together for 42 years.
Wow.
Barry Gibb is 74 today.
Oh, the Bee Gees.
Co-founder of the group, the Bee Gees, one of the most commercially successful groups in the history of popular music. With his younger brothers, Robin and Maurice Gibb, he formed a songwriting partnership that went back to 1955. The first song featuring Gibb's falsetto voice, you know, the real high falsetto, 1975's Nights on Broadway. In 76, he wrote, I Just Want to Be Your Everything. His brother, Andy Gibb's first hit, that he wrote that for him.
Mm-hmm.
Andy Gibb was not part of the Bee Gees.
No.
No.
He was a solo artist and died really early.
And I think they all had some type of illness, didn't they?
Yes.
Yeah, I think they all had cancer at one point or another.
I'm not sure it was cancer. But, everything took off for them in 1977. Saturday Night Fever.
Saturday Night Fever.
Everything went crazy. In May of 2012, Robin Gibb died, and that makes Barry the sole survivor of the Gibb family. Two marriages, five kids. Get a load of this. In 2006, he purchased the former home of country singers Johnny Cash and June Carter Cash, the House of Cash, in Hendersonville, Tennessee. That's a popular place.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Outside of
Nashville.
Yeah. Anyway, they intended to restore it and turn it into a songwriting retreat. The house was destroyed by fire in 2007 while under renovation. So they live in Great Britain now. he and his wife.
They were from Australia originally, weren't they?
There's a connection. They were. They went back and forth between Australia and Great Britain.
Okay.
September 1st, 1887, Emil Berliner filed for a patent for his invention of the lateral cut flat disc gramophone, which eventually Thomas Edison made it work, and it became a record player. In 1906, Jack Combs of the American League Philadelphia Athletics pitched 24 innings against the Boston Red Sox.
They were yelling from the stands in the 21st inning, "Rag arm! Rag arm!"
If only Tommy John was around so that...
Yeah.
But, you know, if you threw 24 innings and you blew out your arm,
yeah,
you were toast back then.
You're pitching 3 days later.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. If you blew out your arm, you were still pitching 3 days later.
1952, Ernest Hemingway's The Old Man and the Sea was published. Mm-hmm. 1970, the last episode of I Dream of Jeannie aired on NBC. The show premiered in 1965, so it was 5 years. And, Barbara Eden was just so fetching in that Jeannie outfit. Wouldn't let you see her belly button, if you remember.
Yeah. I do remember that.
Never saw Larry Hagman's belly button either.
No.
Didn't
That's
want
okay.
To.
Didn't want to see that.
Yeah. 1979, the U.S. Pioneer 11 became the first spacecraft to visit Saturn, and then it would go on beyond Uranus.
You've got to get that word in on every space story.
I'm just trying to be accurate.
Okay.
1982, J.R. Richard returned to the major leagues. He had had a near-fatal stroke, if you remember. He's a great big right-hander for the Astros.
Mm-hmm.
86, Jerry Lewis raised a record $34 million for this weekend, Labor Day weekend.
Labor Day weekend.
Always was the Jerry Lewis.
Right.
I'll never forget calling in to KMOX at about 11 o'clock on like the Sunday night of Labor Day weekend.
Right.
And saying this on open line. I don't think Jerry Lewis has a career anymore. The only thing that he has for a career is these telephones. Hanging up, and there were 3 hours of people beating on me on that show. I stirred it up good.
Yeah.
That's where you started it, huh?
What was the guy's name? White. Jim White was the overnight guy.
Yeah.
The big bumper, I think was what they called him. Anyway, you know what? In 1854, composer Engelbert Humperdinck was born. 1854. There was an original Engelbert Humperdinck, and this guy, Arnold George Dorsey, took his name and became our Engelbert Humperdinck after the love.
Well, I'm sure he was done with it, the original Engelbert Humperdinck.
Yeah. Yes, he was. He's gone. He was decomposing instead of composing. Art George Dorsey. He'll be 85 in May. Engelbert will be. 53. Buddy Holly and Bob Montgomery auditioned for the radio station KDAV in Lubbock, Texas, doing a show. Also on this date, 56, Elvis Presley shared his success with his family by purchasing his mother a pink Cadillac. It's still out. I think it's at Graceland, isn't it? I think it is.
Is it across the street?
Boss Skaggs joined the Steve Miller Band in 67. So there you go. There's all kinds of information from today. Of course, our question of the day, the Carnegie Square question of the day, and I think it goes without saying.
Passion leader.
But I'm going to say it anyway.
You got to whisper it?
Carnegie Square is the fashion leader in downtown Fairfield and has been for 9 to 40 years. The question is, what's something you really resent paying for? We've got some good answers. We'll be back with those answers right here as Rod Stewart and the Faces take us into break on Morning Coffee.
It's Carnegie's last last hurrah. Carnaby's last week for their summer sale, one half off of one half. The store is falling forward with the best trending brands. Carnaby has new deliveries of Tribal, Charlie B, and Brighton. Make a reminder, Carnaby's Trending Thursdays will be starting soon. The Carnaby girls will be taking a long weekend, closing Saturday and returning on Tuesday. Family, friends, and good food is on the agenda. Enjoy and stay safe. God bless America. Don't forget to like and follow Carnaby Square on Facebook.
What's Going On is brought to you by Wainwright County's Electric Cooperative in Fairfield, who remind you that hybrid water heaters are the most energy-efficient way to maintain hot water for your home. If you are a Wainwright Electric customer and you purchase a hybrid electric water heater, you can get a $500 incentive rebate check from Wainwright. Learn more about this rebate online at wainwrightcoop.com. Here's what's going on Saturday, September the 5th. The Mount Airy Raritan Club will be holding its monthly breakfast from 6 to 9 a.m. The menu is biscuits and gravy, sausage patty, scrambled eggs, hash browns, pancakes, orange juice, and coffee. It's $6 for adults, $3 for children. Members will serve the food. Carryouts will be available as well as in-house dining. The 12th annual Wayne County Antique Tractor Drive will be held on Labor Day, Monday, September 7th. All tractors that are model year 1990 or earlier are welcome to participate. Due to COVID-19 guidelines, there will be a hard limit of 40 tractors for this year's drive, and only drivers are allowed to attend the event. Register today by going to waynecfb.com/tractor drive. Check-ins will take place at 8 a.m. at Dag's Auction Company on State Route 161 west of Orchardville.
Jerome here from Main Street Shop in Fairfield. The only bad thing about a Skagmore is when the guy next door gets one and you don't. Oh, look, he's getting his lawn done in half the time and you don't. He's only buying half the gas he used to and you don't. And to top it all off, his lawn looks way better and yours don't. Help me out here. What was the reason again why you don't get a Skag, that is? We are Main Street Shop in Fairfield, and we have a Skag for you, too. Just saying. Wow, zoom, dude. Wow, zoom.
Going beyond the expected. It's what they do at Pekin Insurance, and it's been their way of doing business since 1921. It's service that goes the extra mile and products that provide the flexibility to meet all of today's insurance needs and tomorrow's as well. Stop by and see Randy Hallam or John Emetter at Tucker Hallam Insurance in Wayne City. They will provide you with the financial protection and peace of mind you need and deserve. Tucker Hallam Insurance and Pekin, beyond the expected.
Time Capsule, sponsored today by Save-A-Lot Food Store on West Main, Fairfield.
Hi, this is Bill Stevens with another Time Capsule quiz. Which month and year was it when Patty Hearst was convicted of bank robbery? Jimmy Carter won 3 presidential primaries and became the Democratic frontrunner. On the Republican side, President Ford won 4 in a row over challenger Ronald Reagan. In college hoops, undefeated Indiana brought home the first national title for coach Bobby Knight. One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest became the first film in 42 years to sweep the Oscars for Best Picture, Director, Actress, and Actor.
I guess this proves there are as many nuts in the Academy as anywhere else.
Meanwhile, the best radio station in town was playing hits like these. Those songs were big winners when they hit the air, but when did they? The answer and a touch of the top song from the month and year are coming up.
Get ready for your Labor Day weekend with these great deals at your Fairfield Save-A-Lot. Family pack beef ribeyes, $5.99 a pound. Family pack of T-bone steaks, $4.69 a pound. Whole boneless pork loins, $1.87 a pound. And 80/20 ground beef, $2.97 a pound. Prices mentioned are good through Saturday. Good food, great people, great prices at your Save-A-Lot store located on West Main.
March 1976.
Johnny Taylor and Disco Lady, the top song of March 1976. This is Bill Stevens for TCapsule.com. Back soon with another Time Capsule.
Time Capsule has been sponsored today by Save-A-Lot Food Store on West Main, Fairfield.
You know what sounds fun?
holiday world sounds fun. We're talking the kind of fun that takes 128 acres to contain it. The kind of fun that leads to the sounds of silence on the car ride home. Because the kids will be sleeping. The kind of fun you need to start having today. But you can only get tickets online and only at holidayworld.com.
Free stocking! Free parking! Free sunscreen!
That was fun.
Eubinger's Furniture cares about our customers. So to help you with your furniture and bedding purchases, we're offering up to 4 years free financing. Minimum purchase and approval required. See store for details. At Eubinger's, we have everything you need to make your home more comfortable. It's time to sink into a comfy new recliner, sofa, or luxurious new mattress. So shop now with no money down and up to 4 years free financing. Only at Eubinger's Furniture Company, where the deal's worth a drive. Highway 50 East, Flora.
It's here. The Big Deal Store is online and waiting for you to shop and buy gift certificates to local businesses. Go to your station's website, WFIWradio.com, and click on Big Deals. Here you'll find dozens of gift certificates for places like Three Chicks Fudgery, Act Tire and Auto, Boyd Furniture and Mattress Center, and Bullard's Farm Market and Bakery. You can shop 24 hours a day and save tons of money in the process. But you better hurry. You never know how long each deal will last.
Back on Morning Coffee with the Carnaby Square question of the day. What is something you really resent paying for? And I'm going to just start it off. I resent paying for water and air. And what I mean by that is bottled water. I used to drink water out of a hose when I was a kid.
Mm-hmm. Okay? And it tasted good.
It had a nice sort of aftertaste to it, that rubber aftertaste. Yeah. You had to get the water going so it was cool.
Yeah, right.
You had to get it going for a little bit.
But
when you first started, it was hot.
A couple of bucks for a bottle of water for some reason just grates me. Okay?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And over on this side, I love it when I can get air at a convenience store for my tires.
Yeah.
Without having to chuck in a couple
right.
of quarters. That bothers me as well.
It's more than a couple of quarters now.
What is
it? It's like a dollar and a quarter now.
Yeah.
For air. Bothers me. How about you guys?
That works for me.
Air. Yeah.
Yeah.
We once did a skit at church.
You don't mind.
I was like, look, they got free air here. Free air. They had a big sign. Free air.
Let's stick it in my tire then. All right. Most people focused on taxes here. Okay.
Yeah,
in our answers. Yeah. Property taxes. Here's Mark was upset about property or about taxes on used car tax.
Mm-hmm.
That kind of hit us out of the blue here not that long ago. He doesn't think it should be legal. Cameron said, having lived in a few bigger areas, parking bothered him.
Yeah, I can see that.
Oh, that was a big problem in St. Louis. In St. Louis, they had those. The technology based where you had to have a card or something like that.
You have an app now.
Oh, no. I wouldn't want
that.
That used to drive me crazy. That did drive me crazy when I was in St. Louis.
You know what else burns me a little bit? Paying to cross a bridge.
A toll. Any kind of toll.
A toll bridge.
Anytime I'm in in Chicago, I zoom past the toll thing, and then I get a ticket a month later.
Yeah.
Because they've taken a picture of my license plate. You know, and my license plate gives me away most of the time.
Yeah. That's what you get for having one.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Rob says the outrageous cost of trash pickup in Fairfield. He thinks that's outrageous.
Okay. Yeah.
Boom. Here's one. Now, I didn't realize this. At least one restaurant in town does this. Okay? I'm not going to cough it up.
Mm-hmm.
Added charge for using a debit card. Did you know that?
There's more than one restaurant in Fairfield.
I did not realize
this. There's two. I know another one, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, I do know another one.
And, you know, to me, speaking of a business owner, that's just part of doing business.
Right. But they're passing along a cost that they're...
Yeah, it's an extra like 50 cents or something. Or 60 cents or whatever.
Yeah.
Dave says, for channels on DirecTV that have numerous commercials. Okay.
All right, well.
Truck parking, Scott says. Insurance, Betty says. Rob's kind of mad at the electricity to the city. You know, they're kind of behind the eight ball there in the city. Keith says taxes. That's pretty general. Convenience fees for removing license plates.
What?
I've never heard of that before. What do you mean?
A convenience fee.
For renewing license.
For renewing
license. Oh,
yes.
Oh, that makes sense. You know, I need to get my eyes worked on.
I think you do. You know, if you go to get your license plate sticker,
yes,
you either write a check or pay cash, or they do charge you an extra fee at the DMV.
There you go. That's what he's upset about. There's a lot of people that are upset about using debit cards and getting charged.
A lot of some gas stations will do that as well.
Well, you know, if you use your card so many times in a month, don't they add a charge at the bank? You know,
well,
that's kind of upsetting too.
The bank maintenance fee.
Yeah.
Get a load of this one. This is great.
I use my money more than you thought I should.
You know who I'm. You're going to know who I'm talking about here. I usually try to keep people, you know, just their first names. But Diana says, water at fast food places after I'm buying from them food. You know. I want water with it, and then charge it. Here's what Gordy says about that. What bothers him is giving money to Diana Toombs for water at fast food places.
How Gordy is still married, I'll never know.
He's a gem. He's a gem. Everybody knows it. Boy, there's just all kinds of... somebody upset about a roofing job they had. That costs.
Yeah.
Somebody's upset about the dentist. Here's a guy I'm sure is out there listening. His name is Red Hog.
Red Hog.
Yeah, Red Hog, H-A-W-G.
Okay. Red Hog.
He doesn't like having to pay for radio. I want some of that money. Listen. From now on, you just put the quarter in the front of your radio. In fact, morning coffee is four quarters.
Actually, we've got a drop
when
box
it gets
out
full,
here at the front door.
We'll come by and pick it up.
Out of your car.
I'm assuming he's talking about Sirius XFM or something like that.
Well, I'd hope, but who would want to go there? Red Hog is upset about radio. And how much we charge people to listen. And if you're listening and you're not paying, we need to talk, okay?
No, we know who you are.
We can see, we can see you there.
We can hear you.
All right. Well, there's more, but mostly it's around taxes. That's what we've got most of all. Did you hear about the guy in Park Rapids, Minnesota? He's taking his hairstyle to new heights. Joseph Grismore set a new Guinness Book of World Record by achieving the world's tallest full Mohican mohawk. I've got an inverted mohawk that I wear. The hairdo stands over 42 inches in height and required half a can of hairspray to keep it vertical.
Is that Aquanet?
Man.
42 inches. Think about that. You'd have to have a lot of hairspray. You'd have to have some hairspray there.
Mm-hmm. Well, Bud Light is hiring a chief. Is it meme?
Meme?
M-E-M-E?
Yeah.
Meme? Okay. Chief meme officer to promote its line of hard seltzers. The beer brand admits its memes are trash and says they need help bad. Job requires 10 memes a week and pays $5,000 a month for 3 months. You can apply by September 18th if you're interested. What is a meme? I don't even know what a meme is.
Here's our technology.
It's a picture.
Group. All right.
Picture with a saying on it that you see on Facebook or on Instagram or any of your other social media sites.
Okay, so what's a GIF?
A GIF is just a picture. It's a picture format.
Okay.
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 Well, here's something from New York.
As mud.
There you go.
Ripping just one license plate in half may seem impossible to most people, but a New York man is making it look easy. He tore through an impressive 29 plates in 60 seconds. It was enough to beat his own world record of 23 from 2 years ago. There's another world record.
A meaningless.
Now, let me tell you something. Record. I've got my grandfather's license.
How do you really do that?
Pardon?
How do you...
You just rip them.
What makes you...
Was it one at a time, or did you just rip them all at once?
No.
What makes you go, you know what? I could rip a license plate in half. I bet you I could do a bunch of them.
Looky here. Watch this.
Is there a world record for it?
And he's done it twice.
How do you... alcohol has to be involved someplace.
My my grandpa, and maybe, you know, you used to see this. You know, when we got plates every year?
Yeah.
And they had the numbers on them?
Right.
You know, 1943, 1944. Uh-huh. My grandfather saved every one from his first car in like 1928 or 29 all the way through like 1970. And he had them up on his...
in the workshop or the barn or whatever.
Right.
Yeah.
So when he passed away, we took them all down, and now they're in my man cave. Okay. And the 1941, 42, and 43 were not made with metal.
Oh, yeah. You were telling us about that.
Soybeans.
Yeah.
And
because they needed metal for the
war.
For the war. And you know, sometimes the animals bit into them. Yeah, those would be easy to rip up. I could have gone through those. I could have broken that record if it just had soybean.
That's true.
So what's our topic today?
Movies.
Movies. I'm ready for it.
All right. Number one.
Mm-hmm.
What 1984 movie was the first one ever to be rated PG-13?
1984. I mean, so we've had ours already by that time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This is PG.
They introduced PG-13, which is not quite R.
Let's see who was in this movie. See if I can remember.
Okay, if you do, that'd help.
Patrick Swayze. Jennifer Grey.
Got it.
I got it.
Charlie Sheen. They were all in that movie. Number two. What is the highest grossing movie of all time when taking inflation into account?
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Number three. What's the Los Angeles hotel prominently featured in the movie Pretty Woman?
I don't know.
Number four. Who played Detective Rick Deckard in the movie Blade Runner? The original Blade Runner.
Yeah.
Number five. Who played the Wicked Witch of the West in The Wizard of Oz?
I know her last name.
Number six, what's the name of John Wayne's character in True Grit? Jeff Bridges played this character in the remake of True Grit.
Okay.
All right. Number seven, what Martin Scorsese movie holds the all-time record for F-bombs?
Really?
Yeah. Number eight, John Wayne is killed by a sniper in this war movie about a famous World War II battle.
Okay.
All righty.
Okay.
Number nine, name the actor who played Papa Elf.
Okay.
In Elf.
In the movie Elf.
And number 10, why was Paul Crewe kicked out of the NFL in The Longest Yard? What did he do to get him kicked out of the NFL?
I've got ideas. We'll come back and we'll see if my ideas have any traction. We'll be back after this.
I'm getting older. Do I need to worry about falling?
Yes, you do. Every year, one in four people 65 and older will experience a fall, and many result in serious injury. The majority of falls happen at home, so take a look around. Replace bulbs and add lighting to help you see obstacles. Remove things that can make you trip. Fix uneven steps and floors. And install handrails in bathrooms and on stairs. Consider balance or strength training exercises, which can help with agility. Get your eyes and hearing checked regularly. changes in your hearing can affect your balance. To learn more, please talk to your doctor about steps you can take to help prevent a fall. You can also visit aarpfoundation.org or medicaremadeclear.com/falls. This message was brought to you by United Healthcare and AARP Foundation.
Champion Labs in Albion has gotten new business and they are growing. Come to their hiring event on Thursday, September 3rd from 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. to talk with them about getting a job. Champ is looking to fill assembly and fork truck positions. At Champ, you can find a great job with an opportunity to personally grow and advance. Champ offers generous pay increases and you will be paid weekly. Benefits include insurance, paid holidays, vacation, and a 401k to support you and your family. If you're interested in a general assembly or a fork truck position at Champ, stop by their Albion facility, visit champlabs.com, or come to Champ's hiring event on Thursday, September 3rd from 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Champion Labs in Albion is an equal opportunity employer. In Southern Illinois, the outside temperature changes daily. Let Right Nower HVAC keep Mother Nature outside where she belongs and keep your home comfortable inside. Right Nower HVAC can service your existing system 24 hours a day. Or if you're in the market for a new system altogether, Right Nower will install a new Rood HVAC unit or a Hydron geothermal unit. All major credit cards are accepted, or talk to Brian about financing options. Find them on Facebook at Brian Right Nower HVAC or call 214-2593 for 24/7 service.
Watermelons.
Healthy.
Cool.
And tasty.
They're grown here and are at the peak of freshness right now.
The Ileana Watermelon Association reminds you that every summer day is better with watermelon.
Bring one home today.
Watermelon.
Cooler temperatures means that Uniquely Rustique has fall merchandise to spruce up your space. Fall flags, flowers, and decorations. And parents, school has started. Maybe you're homeschooling or doing virtual learning. Well, Uniquely Rustique can provide supplemental supplies to help with the transition. Stop by and let them assist you. Uniquely Rustique provides delivery to local funeral homes, hospitals, nursing homes, schools, and daycares free of charge. Let them help you brighten someone's day. Call 842-3544.
Location, location, location. Door Auction and Realty is having an online-only auction of the former Southern Illinois Lumber Complex located in the heart of Fairfield. It can be found on our website at doorauctions.com. This highly visible commercial site offers great access. Property features frontage on both east and westbound lanes of U.S. Route 45, plus frontage on 2nd and 3rd Streets. Bidding ends on Monday, September 21st at 7 p.m. Property is being sold subject to seller approval and with a 6% buyer fee.
Your Classic Hits Fairfield area weather forecast, 60% chance for rain today, high 82, 80% chance tonight, low 70, for tomorrow a 50% chance for rain, high 82, clouds and 85 on Thursday, for Friday partly sunny, high 78, and the outlook for Saturday sunshine, high 82. Overnight low 68, yesterday's high was 84. Currently, humidity is at 96%, winds are calm, pressure at 29.92. Cloudy skies right now, 72 at the WFIW studios east of Fairfield. And radar weather still showing some light rain off to the west this morning.
A little Jackson 5. I love it.
Movie trivia this morning.
And you're going to stump us, I'm afraid. Go ahead.
No. Number one. Mm-hmm. 1984 movie was the first movie ever to be rated PG-13.
I'm going to say Dirty Dancing.
Dirty Dancing.
No?
Red Dawn.
Red Dawn.
Red Dawn.
Charlie Sheen was not in Dirty Dancing.
No.
Red Dawn.
Red Dawn.
Yeah. And I think Dirty Dancing came later than 84.
But that's when they started doing PG-13.
Yeah, 84.
Okay. 84.
Number two.
Okay.
What is the highest grossing movie of all time when you take inflation into account?
I'm going to say Gone with the Wind.
I want to say Titanic.
Gone with the Wind.
Gone with the Wind.
Okay, good.
That would be
inflation.
It. Number three, what's the Los Angeles hotel featured in the movie Pretty Woman?
You can hear my...
The Regency?
Beverly Wilshire.
Beverly Wilshire.
Mm-hmm. Number four, who played Detective Rick Deckard in Blade Runner?
Harrison Ford.
Yes, sir.
Good job.
Number five, who played the Wicked Witch of the West in The Wizard of Oz?
Her last name was Hamilton.
Margaret.
Is it Margaret
Hamilton?
Okay.
Went on to become the, was it the Folgers lady?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Or the Maxwell.
I'll get you, my pretty. And your cup of coffee, too.
And a grog, too. All right, number six, what's the name of John Wayne's character in True Grit?
Brewster Cockburn? No?
No.
Yeah.
It was?
Brewster Cockburn.
Okay, good.
Number seven, what Martin Scorsese movie holds the all-time record for F-bombs?
Was it Wolf of Wall Street?
It is the Wolf of Wall Street.
Well, they drop him. I saw it the other night. They drop it quite a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Sure do.
Say taxi driver.
Noun, verb, adverb, object of the preposition. Lots of F-bombs.
All right. John Wayne's character is killed by a sniper in this war movie about a famous World War II battle.
Sands of Iwo Jima?
That's what he would say. How about the Fighting Seabees?
It is the Sands of Iwo Jima.
Okay. Well, he died in the Fighting Seabees as well.
Yes, he did. But he was killed by a sniper in this one.
Well, I mean, what, did somebody jump out and say, hi, I'm not a sniper, and shoot him in Iwo Jima?
No, he was hiding. All right. Number nine, name the actor who played Papa Elf.
Bob Newhart.
Was it?
Yeah.
Yes.
I never watched Elf.
Oh, it's a very good movie.
Oh, yeah. And number 10, why was Paul Crewe kicked out of the NFL in The Longest Yard?
How about he slept with the owner's wife?
Nope.
Not drunk driving, wasn't it?
Nope. That's why he was thrown in prison.
That's why he was thrown in prison.
Because he stole the car.
Gambling?
And drunk driving. Shaving points.
Shaving points.
Shaving points.
There you go.
As he gets it, gets that.
All right. Well,
cream all over the points paid. Because
you remember
you shave
in the
them.
Movie, Caretaker, in one of the scenes says, why'd you shave them points?
Yeah. He still won or lost, one of the two, but he shaved points. That'd be he won. All right. Well, you guys are going to. Kenody's going to be in the.
Ken's going to be here.
Levine seat.
I'll be over there.
You'll be over here. And
you'll be there.
You'll be in the co-pilot's
chair. And then the next
chair.
Day, you'll be gone. And
Yep. I'm not going to be here long.
We'll move things around again.
You know what? We like to keep that. Everybody kind of off guard.
Yeah.
Keep the circular motion going.
That's what's going to happen tomorrow. So.
Well, you know, it keeps the circulation flowing.
Yes, it does. Come back here tomorrow.
All right.
The guys will take care of it, and you'll get to hear from KO. And so stay right here.
Right. Thank you. And hope everything goes well.
Oh, yeah. Well, I hope to see better come later in the week. Take care.
All righty.
Alexa, play WFIW.
It's time for classic hits from WFIW.
It's what you've been looking for. WFIW-FM Fairfield, Illinois, and WFIWradio.com, the news leader in southeastern Illinois.
Time now for the news, brought to you by Boyd Furniture and Mattress Center in downtown Wayne City, where there's everyday low prices on Serta, Ashley, Catnapper, and Benchcraft mattresses.
Fox News, I'm Chris Foster. President Trump says he's going to Kenosha, Wisconsin today to support the community and thank